Testing. Hello. Hello. No, go ahead. No, do your thing. I'm fixing my mic. Hello, testing. 1, 2, 3. Hello.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. Good father, it's who you are. peace so unexplainable. I can hardly think as you call me, deeper still as you call.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name, sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship your holy name. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the the Lord.
The end draws near and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then
stars they fled, the morning sun was dead, the Savior of the world was fallen, his body on the cross, his blood poured out for us, the weight of every curse upon him. Heaven looked away, the sun
Good morning on this beautiful Mother's Day. Let's all stand and worship.
Water you turned into wine, open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you, none like you. Darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God turned into wine, open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you, there's none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, there's none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God's healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God, our God is greater, our our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God.
Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah. He is greater, correct? Amen. He's greater than all of our issues, all of our problems. He's greater than the rain that's outside. So I'm happy you all are here with us this morning. You can turn and wave at each other. We're still not doing the greetings thing. Soon, hopefully soon, we'll be shaking each other's hands again. I want to do that so bad. And if you have your offering, it goes in the box in the back, on the back table. So you can do that during the next part of worship if you would like. With that, you may be seated. We have a few announcements we're going to go over. First off, ladies, we have this in the back for you. So before you leave, make sure you grab one of these, ladies. It's a journal that I believe you'll enjoy. There's stickers on the inside. I know my wife looked inside. She goes, ooh, stickers. So I'm sure you guys will like those. You ladies will like those. Also, if you haven't gotten your bulletin yet, this is what it looks like. It's pink this week. So on the inside is a bunch of good stuff. For example, it says, Happy Mother's Day. We want to honor all the extraordinary women here today with a special gift. Go ahead and pick up your gift. So also today we are going to be collecting the baby bottles for Pregnancy Care Center. So if you have those, turn those in to Ellie. She's in the gym area today. So either drop those off with her or in the Welcome Center. Graduation Sunday is May 23rd. Info is due today. We need to know your information so we can honor you, so we can get your gift. We can not embarrass you at all on the 23rd. Let me be honest with you. Graduation Sunday historically has been one of my favorite Sundays of the year. I always try to do it really well for our seniors when I was a youth pastor, and I want to continue that into the future. So exercise class Tuesday and Thursday at 10 for those that are old enough to join. I'm not old enough, so if I go down there, they'll kick me out. So, so it's not a ladies thing. Oh, I don't know. Ask Betty if you can go. Guys down there, okay, good. I didn't want to speak out of turn and be wrong, so good. So as long as you're over 65, you're welcome to go. Also, every fifth Sunday is Family Sunday, so there'll be no kids' church every fifth Sunday. Kids will be staying with you. It'll be a good time. Honestly, I really feel like our kids need to be in here when we worship, when we pray, because they need to see their parents going after God. I hope they see it at home, but they need to see us doing it as well. And honestly, we need to see them worshiping God. It'll encourage us and lift up our spirits when we see little children just going after God. So every fifth Sunday, we'll be doing that. If you're new, text WELCOME to this number. If you want to stay updated, text CONNECT to the same number, and we will get you on the proper list. Also, if you are new with us today, or if we haven't seen you in a really, really long time, fill this out and take it back to the Welcome Center. We have a gift for you. If you did not get one of these, let us know, and somebody will get you one of these, or just go and fill one out at the Welcome Center, and then we will give you a really special gift. You don't want to miss out on what we have for you. Also, I have a card from Melissa and her family. As we all know, she had surgery and she needed help. So she says, thank you so much for all the food and cards after my surgery. We appreciate your generosity, love, and prayers so much. So I just want to let you know about that. With that, we're going to go ahead and stand up and we're going to get ready for our second part of worship this morning. I really prayed about starting off the second time of worship with a different verse, but God keeps leading me back to Psalm 95. So I want to read this to you this morning, and I want to encourage you that worship is more than just coming and singing songs. It's more than just watching John and Brenda and Kay up here on the stage. It is a time for us to encounter the living God. It's a time for our hearts to reach out and connect with His heart. That if we have hurts, if we have any issues, it's a time for us to give those to Him and focus on Him in this time. A lot of times in worship, if we focus our eyes on God, our problems really don't seem as big as we think they are. And so we need to focus on God this morning. It says in Psalm 95, 1 and 2, and then verse 6, it says, come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us do that really quick before we worship. Anything that you have going on, let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let's lift up our voices. Let's shout off the things of this world that have been weighing heavy on our hearts. Lord, we worship you, Jesus. We worship you this morning. You are our King. You are our Savior. We shout aloud to you, Lord. Yes, Lord. It says, come, let us come before Him with thanksgiving. Lift up your thanksgivings to God. Thank Him for your day. Thank you for breath in your lungs this morning. Oh, we thank you that you've given us another day. We thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for life. Oh, we give you our thanksgivings. It says, and extol Him with music and song. Verse 6 says, come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. Psalm 42, 2 and 5 says this, my soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When can I go and meet with God? Why, my soul, are you downcast? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise Him, my Savior and my God. Verse 7, deep calls out to deep. In the roar of your waterfalls, all your waves and your breakers have swept over me. During this time, these next few songs, let the deep part of your spirit cry out to the deep part of God. Connect with Him this morning. Connect with Him in this time, in these songs that we have. So, Lord, we give you these next few moments. And Lord, we ask, Lord God, that our deep will cry out to your deep, that our soul will connect with you, and that we will lift up our eyes to you, we'll give you thanksgiving, and we will bow down in worship before our King.
You were the Word at the beginning, one with God the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you, our Christ. What a beautiful name it is, what a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is, nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. You did, and what heaven without us? So Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sin was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. Oh, we worship you. Praise your name, Lord. Death could not hold you, the veil tore before you. You silenced the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory. For you are raised to life again. You have no rival, you have no equal, now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is. Nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is. Nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. Lord, we lift up your name right now. We worship your name. There is no other name, Lord Jesus, besides your name. No other name can heal. No other name can save. No other name can redeem. No other name can deliver, Lord Jesus. Only you. We worship your name. We praise your name, Lord. We glorify your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Sing with me this morning.
Lord, I want more of you. Living water rain down on me. Lord, I need more of you. Living breath of life, come fill
Lord, I need more of you. Living breath of life, come fill me up.
We are hungry.
We are hungry. We are hungry. We are hungry for more of you. We are thirsty, oh Jesus. We are thirsty for more of you.
Holy Spirit. To him this morning and give him all the praise that he deserves, as we want to touch him this morning. We want to touch him with our praises and our love. So sing this to him this morning.
Thank you.
Let's just take a few moments and let's just spend some time praying, spend some time going after God for the next 5 minutes, church. The altars are open. If you need to come down and surrender things to God this morning, the altars are open. If you need healing this morning, the altars are open. If you just have a burden to cry out and pray for lost loved ones and friends who need Jesus, you're for. The altars are open. You can make an altar where you're at right now. But let's spend the next 5 minutes praying and going after God. Prayer is an act of worship. And today I want us to focus, if you find something else to pray for, pray for the missionaries we had last week, the chapels, as they get ready to go to Hungary. So pray for them this morning. Let's spend 5 minutes going after God, church. Stand up. Let's all stand up and let's just go after God. Let's ask Him to move in a new way in our church. Let's ask Him to let His kingdom come. Let His will be done in our church as it is in heaven. Oh Lord, we cry out to You, Father, that Your will be done in our church, Lord God. In our city, Lord God. In our lives, Father. Lord, we're hungry for You. Jesus, come. Have Your way in our services. Oh, Jesus, 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 Jesus. The name above all other names. Have Your way, Jesus. Have Your way, Jesus. Woo. Let's just cry out to Him. Let's say, if you're not feeling hungry this morning, let's ask God to rise up a hunger in our spirits, a hunger for more of Him, a desperation. Lord, let Your fire fall in our lives. Let Your fire fall in our lives. Come on, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. We are hungry, Jesus. We are hungry. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. If you're sick here today, or you know someone who's sick, who needs a fresh touch, who needs a healing from God, I want you to go ahead and lift up your hands across this room. I see those hands. We see them all around. If you need a fresh touch or know someone that does, let's cry out to God. Let's ask Him for healing. He is the God that heals us. Woo. You are the God that heals us, Father. Jesus, You didn't hang on the cross for nothing. You died on the cross. so we could be healed, so we could have new life. So, Lord, I pray right now, Lord, I ask you to speak the word. Speak the word, Lord, we ask. We pray, we cry out to you for healing. For healing on all those who can't make it here this morning. Lord, I pray that you'll touch them where they're at right now, Holy Spirit. Oh, we ask you for your fresh touch right now. Woo. Cancer, you have to flee. Heart defects, you have to flee. Breathing issues, lungs, you have to clear up. Backs, spines, you need to line up right now in Jesus' name. Lord, we ask you, Father, for healing. You said if we ask anything in your name, your Father in heaven will do them. So, Lord, we're asking right now for healing in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, Holy Spirit. We want to see you move. Woo. As we go into the next part of our worship, let's continue to pray. Let's continue to lift these things up to him. But let's sing these songs in faith, knowing that he is going to do great things in our lives.
I love you. Oh, your mercy never fails me, and all my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I know you as a father, I know you as a friend, and I have been in the goodness of God. Life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am in, I will sing of the goodness of God. For all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. With my life laid down, I've surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. With my life. laid down. I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Lord, we're so thankful this morning for your goodness. Lord Jesus, your goodness keeps running after us, Lord Jesus. You chase us down, Lord, to bless us. We thank you. We glorify your name, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Adam, can you put up verse 2 again? That song. Recently in prayer, I was worshiping with this song, and the Lord began to speak to me about this. You've led me through the fire. In darkest night, you're close like no other. That's a picture of difficult times in our life, hard times that we go through, that the Lord is there with us. And the Holy Spirit reminded me of something that, I don't know, maybe you know all about it, and maybe not, I don't know, but it came to my mind. There's a Japanese practice called kintsugi. They take a piece of pottery that's precious to them, and it's broken, and they mend it back together, and then after it's mended, they highlight all of those cracks with either silver or gold. It's called precious pottery. And then there's another phrase that they use after it's already been completed. It's called wabi-sabi, the beauty of imperfection. And they see beauty in that vase that has been covered, or not totally covered, but highlighted with gold. And it represents the fact that we go through periods in our life that are sometimes even devastating to us, where we feel broken. But then we come through that, and we're on the other side, and we're better for it. Every analogy that we make concerning God, regardless of what it is, the circumstances, the analogy, the person making the analogy, whatever it is, it falls short. Because we cannot describe God completely in human terms. And while we may paint a piece of pottery, God makes us new. If you're here this morning and you're a child of God, you have been covered completely in the blood of Jesus Christ, which the Bible tells us is more precious than gold and silver. And we've been made new. We're not being repaired. We've been restored. Somebody needs to hear this morning. God wants you to know that you're not damaged goods, that God has restored you, and you're in right standing with God. Amen? Amen? So I want you to think about that as we sing this final song. Let the Holy Spirit speak to you concerning your relationship with God. Amen.
Purify my heart, Let me be as gold and precious silver, purify my heart. Let me be as gold, pure gold, refiner's fire. My heart's one desire is to be from my sin and make me holy, purify my heart, cleanse me from my sin, deep within me, refiner's fire.
Prayer this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus, we choose. It's our choice. We choose to be holy. We choose to be set apart, Lord Jesus. We choose to do your will, Lord. We glorify your name and we bless you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Yes, hallelujah. Lord. Lord, you are beautiful. You are awesome, Lord. We love you today. Let's just give him a hand. Let's give him a clap offering. Lord, it's you that we worship. Yes, Lord. We worship you this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, I wanted you to know, I don't know if you noticed, but our morning services are bathed in prayer. Wednesday nights are dedicated to prayer. And listen, before we move on to the next part of our service, I want to invite you out on Wednesday nights. Man, it is getting, the atmosphere is getting hot here on Wednesday nights. God is starting to do something new in our church, and it's bleeding over into our Sunday morning services. We're being intentional about how we're praying. We're clearing ground around our church and in our city intentionally through prayer. And God is going to do a new thing in this church. He's already doing it. Amen. All right, so there's your invitation. Every Wednesday night at 7 o'clock, you're welcome to join us for prayer. You may be seated. All right. Well, happy Mother's Day, mothers. And we all have a mother or have had a mother sometime in our life, I hope. So, God sees, you know, if your mom's no longer around, he sees the hurt in your heart, and he knows that you still want to say Happy Mother's Day to your mom. I texted my mom this morning. I'll call her again later today. Say Happy Mother's Day. So I want to say Happy Mother's Day to all you lovely mothers in this church. And with that, we're going to watch a video honoring mothers and how us dads think that it's easy to do your job, but we find out it's not.
Are you guys sure you got this?
Yeah. The twins are plugged in, baby's asleep. How hard can this get?
We're men. Besides, I bumped into Chuck Norris at a Pizza Hut once. I think his power's rubbed off on me.
Get out of here. Go on, enjoy your mommy getaway weekend. Oh, this weekend was a bad idea. Do you remember what happened last time we watched the kids?
I'm not a piñata!
Yeah, we're gonna need help.
Warning, use of this product may alter your perception of reality. All right, everything looks the same. This is a joke.
Guys. Guys, it's like the Sahara in this cup. Can somebody hit me with some juice? And listen, pulp, no pulp, doesn't make a difference to me. You're the ones dealing with the diaper.
Mom goggles!
It's beautiful!
Okay, sweetie, I need you to sit on your bottom. Listen to Daddy. You sit on your bottom, okay? Daddy's gonna come get you. Don't move. Don't dance. Just sit on your bottom. Daddy's gonna come get you.
Whoa. Don't you try to stop me.
Baby made a poopy, yes you did.
Where are your mom goggles?
They wouldn't fit over my hazmat suit.
Take this.
Oh, you're so cute.
And then the little boy, he rocked his mommy. Oh, I love you. Forever. I like you too.
I don't know how I do it.
Oh, well, you take it and you fold it from corner to corner.
No, I'm asking the question, how do moms do all of this? How do they handle it all?
Well, maybe they have goggles we don't know about.
It's as if God gave moms a special way of looking at things, you know? Okay, who taught you servanthood? Who modeled grace? Who gave you a taste of what God's love could look like?
My mom, Mr. T, and my mom.
Anyway, I just think God gave moms a special way of looking at things. Hey, honey.
Hey, how's it going at home?
It's all good. Guess you could say I'm starting to catch a glimpse of what your world looks like.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Mama.
Hold on, your daughter wants to say something to you.
I think Mama.
She says she misses you. And she realizes how important you are in her life. And she doesn't know how you do it. And she knows that she can't make it without you.
She said all that, huh?
I don't know if she said it. But it's what I wanted to say. And I should have said it a lot sooner. I thank God for you.
The twins.
It was nothing. We have to go, okay? Love you, Mommy.
So there's a little humor for you, Mother's this Sunday morning. Happy Mother's Day one last time. So if you have your Bibles, please turn with me to John chapter 19. We're going to take a little look at a verse that's always stuck out to me, and I thought it would be a good one to look at for Mother's Day this year. Before we do, let's go ahead and pray. And it's going to be Matthew 19. We're going to be reading verse 26 and 27 this morning. Lord, I thank you so much, Lord, just for how good you are. Lord, thank you for a glimpse of how good you are that we had this morning. Lord, I thank you, Lord God, that you are already ministering to our hearts. And Lord, I thank you, Lord God, that you want to bring healing to us today. So Lord, I pray that you'll take these next few moments. Lord, I pray that you'll be glorified in them, Lord God. Let us hear the words you want us to hear, and let us apply it to our life today. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. This verse is at the end, towards the end of Jesus. Jesus is towards the end of his life. He is on the cross. The Romans have already separated his clothes. They've already cast lots for his tunic. And his disciples, all but one, have deserted him. It's so funny how I'll have an idea of where I'm going to go with the message, and then I keep reading the scripture over and over and over, and God keeps bringing more and more stuff out to me. Like this morning, as I was praying in here, God showed me another thing, and I threw it in there really quick. But everybody left Jesus except for his mom and her friends. His mom followed him to the cross. What a mother's heart. She saw him come into the world, and she saw him leave the world before he came back. And in this moment of sorrow, in this moment of heartache, Jesus looks down from the cross, sees his mom standing there, and says these words: when Jesus saw his mother there and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to her, "Woman, here is your son." and to the disciple, here is your mother. From that time on, this disciple took her into his home. I want us to realize, and I already mentioned it briefly, but everyone had abandoned Jesus except for his mom and her friends. Actually, his mom, his aunt, and then some other ladies that he had had impact in her life. It says in Matthew 26:56, then all the disciples deserted him and fled. In this hardest, most pivotal moment, we see the soldiers, they took charge of him. They made him carry his cross on a hill, up to the hill. They made him carry his mode of execution. We don't even make our prisoners who are on death row carry their mode of execution with them. You don't ask for somebody who's getting lethal injection to carry the poison that's going to go into his veins with him to the room. Back when they lined him up for a firing squad, they didn't ask him to carry the rifles that were going to shoot them. But the Romans, they asked Jesus to carry his cross up the hill. And there they crucified him with two others, one on each side and in the middle. We're in verse 16 through 27. Pilate, he decided to add insult to injury, and he wrote a sign and placed it above Jesus, says, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews. And the Jews didn't like it, and they asked him to take it down. And they said, do not write King of the Jews, but that this man claimed to be King of the Jews. And Pilate answered, what I have written, I have written. When the soldiers crucified Jesus, they took his clothes, dividing them into four shares. And then they cast lots for his undergarment. And near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. And when Jesus saw his mother there, so in the midst of all of this pain, all of this insult, all of this stuff that's going on around Jesus, he took a moment to look at his mother and cared for her. That gets me every time I think about it. How Jesus saw his mom in the middle of his suffering, was not selfish saying, God, get me out of here, let's end this quickly. But instead he took care and made sure his mom was taken care of. Jesus loved his mother. Such a human thing. Such an amazing thing. We can understand two things in this one little statement of woman, behold your son, and son, here is your mother. We can understand that not only did Mary care for Jesus, because she risked a lot by following him to the cross. Remember, Peter denied Jesus three times. He was his steadfast disciple. They were looking for people to accuse and say, weren't you with him? But the mother said, I don't care. I will see my son. I will be there for him until the very end. Jesus cared. Not only did Mary care for Jesus, but Jesus cared for his mom. I believe that at this moment in Mary's heart, she is wondering, who will take care of me now? She's at the cross watching her oldest son die. She's a widow, probably thinking, who will take care of me now? And Jesus heard her request in her heart and answered her request and said, there's the disciple who loves me. He has so much love in his heart, he can take care of you as well. So son, here is your mother. Mother, here is your son. Jesus wasn't the hope for his disciples who thought he was going to overthrow Rome, but also his mom had hope that he would take care of her. And Jesus saw this, and that is why he said what he said. Let's look back, though, at the story of Jesus and Mary briefly. We don't have a ton of incidences with Mary in the Bible, and that's fine. Mary is just another person, just like us. But there's a story of Jesus and Mary, a mother's love. Mary was a caring mother. Caring mother. She risked her whole popularity when she carried Jesus, when she allowed herself to be pregnant with him outside of wedlock. That was not as easy then as it is now. There's a lot more there's a lot more public outcry about that stuff back then and gossip. She had faith in her son's abilities. The first miracle that he performed, he wasn't ready to perform his first miracle. I don't know if you know the story of her, of him turning the water into wine. I always love that story. It cracks me up. He's at a wedding and they're running out of wine, and Mary's like, son, they need more wine. He's like, mother, my time is not yet here. And she said, do whatever he says. He's like, yes, mother. I don't know about you guys. I don't know, but I've experienced that a few times where mom knew better. Even though Jesus knew better than his mom, obviously, because he was the Son of God. But he obeyed his mom when she had a request for him. Why? Because she had faith in the abilities of what he was going to be able to do. Before he showed himself to the world, she knew what Jesus could do. She believed in her son. And then Jesus honored his mother by turning the water into wine. She was concerned. She was a concerned mother. We see in Matthew chapter 12, verse 46 through 50, where it says, Jesus was talking to the crowd. His mother and his brothers stood outside wanting to speak to him. Someone told him, your mother and brothers are standing outside wanting to speak to you. He replied to him, who is my mother and who are my brothers? Pointing to his disciples, he said, here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of my Father in heaven is my brother and sister and mother. There's another account, I believe it's in Luke, where they came to take him away because they thought he had gone mad. Because everybody was angry with Jesus. I don't think she came because she doubted him. I think she came to collect him because she was concerned. She knew all these people wanted to hurt her son. And she wanted to take him home and keep him safe. And he said no. He said no. I'm where I need to be. She was a concerned mother. And she came to collect him. And Jesus, I don't think he was insulting his mother when he was pointing out, when he said this thing in Matthew chapter 12. I believe that instead he was pointing out that to have an intimate relationship with him, you don't have to be blood family, but instead do the will of his Father in heaven. Jesus, Mary became a Jesus follower. She followed her son. First as a concerned, loving mother, then as a disciple herself. She knew who his real father was and who Jesus was before his disciples did. She followed him all the way to the cross. And while she knew that he was supposed to suffer, it had to be the hardest thing in the world to watch him be condemned, beaten, and hung on the cross. But in the midst of all this suffering, Jesus never stopped caring for his mother. He made sure in his final moments to take care of his mother, to make sure she was taken care of. Her story, though, wasn't over at that point. Her story wasn't over at that point. We see her again in Acts chapter 1, verse 14. Right before the day of Pentecost, when all the believers, it says this, they all joined together constantly in prayer, along with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. The same brothers who tried to collect him earlier were now followers of Jesus. I believe, this is where my mind goes sometimes. I read this and then we don't hear any more about Mary, but I'm wondering if she was one of the 120 in the upper room. And since we don't know or don't know, we don't know if it's true or not, then just let my imagination run away with myself and think that she was. And how cool is the thought that she not only physically carried Jesus in her body, then all of a sudden she had Jesus in her heart and she was filled with the Holy Spirit. She had an experience that none of us will ever really have. I just think it's kind of cool, that's all. I don't think she's any more special than us, Jesus, but I believe Jesus died for her just as much as he died for you and me. Without his sacrifice on the cross, she would not have access to heaven. Jesus died for her, just like he died for you and me. So the first thing I see is that I see a beautiful thing, that Jesus loved his mother. We can take courage in that. We can take joy in that he loved his mom. But not only that, but Jesus cares for our hurts. Jesus not only cared for his mom, but in this little statement, I see how he actually cares for us. How he actually still cares for us. It says this in Psalm 147, verse 3. It's on the marquee outside, that he heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. Matthew 5, 4, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Jesus cares for the hurting. Mary was hurting when she saw her son dying on the cross, and he cared for her. How much more will he care for us now that he's sitting at the right hand of God and up in heaven, looking down, and he sees our issues, he sees our hurts. Jesus, he cares for the hurting, for those who feel abandoned and forgotten. He loves them. And he wants to take care of them, just like he made sure to take care of his mother in the last moments of his life. Jesus wants to see our wounds healed. But we need to admit that they are there. One thing that gets me about Psalm 147:3, about him binding up the brokenhearted, is that we have to allow him to have access to our brokenness. A lot of times we get hurt, we get wounded, we get brokenhearted, and we want to cover up that brokenness. We don't want to let other people see. We don't want to admit it to God. But see, unless we expose our wounds to God, he cannot bind those wounds. He cannot heal those things that are broken in our hearts. Unless we mourn, we cannot be comforted. Jesus wants you to mourn. He wants you to feel your feelings. Not stuff them down, but know that they are there. So you can become healed emotionally. You can be healed spiritually. You can be healed physically. Jesus wants to bring healing to you today. He sees your hurts. He wants to see our wounds healed. Way too often we cover them up because we see them as unspiritual. But if we don't accept that they are there, if we don't feel our feelings, God can't heal them. We need to learn to mourn, to be sad. We need to allow ourselves to hurt so that Jesus can bind up our broken hearts. Because of this, we also need to learn to love and take care of those who feel forgotten and alone. See, the other half of this verse was, son, behold your mother. One thing I learned while I was studying for this is that Mary's cousin is most likely John's mom. And John was the disciple that Jesus loved. See, John didn't need another mother. See, I always assumed that Jesus gave John his mother because he needed a mother as well. But no, John didn't need another mother. But John loved, had such a capacity for love that he was willing to take care of Jesus' mom. And so as believers, we need to learn to have a capacity to allow the Holy Spirit to help us love others when they're hurting. Because he wants to use us to bring healing to others. And just like he saw the needs of Mary, he sees our needs as well, even if we don't verbalize them. So what now? What do we do with this little verse that, I'll be quite frank, I've never preached on before in my life? What do we do with this little verse? What do we learn from this? Jesus himself modeled in this little verse how we need to take care of others. Philippians 2, 3, and 4 says this, "Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interests, but to each of you to the interests of others." We need to be like Jesus and learn to take care of our mothers, of others in our church that are hurting. You may not have a mom today, but you can adopt a mom. Find somebody, learn, get to know somebody who needs just to be loved on and be taken care of. Well, I already have my mom. My mom's around. That's great. But listen, one thing I love to do is I love just to get to know people and just sort of take you under my wing and just love on you, even if your kids are still around. Because that's what God has called us to do. Jesus emphasized this and took issue with the religious of the day. He says in Matthew 15, 3 and 6, he says, "Why do you break the command of God for the sake of your tradition? For God said, honor your father and mother, and anyone who curses their father or mother is to be put to death. But you say that if anyone declares that what might have been used to help their father or mother is devoted to God, they are not to honor their father or mother with it. Thus, you nullify the word of God for the sake of your tradition." Jesus himself emphasized that we need to take care and honor our father and our mother. And we need to honor those around us and take care of those around us who need our help. Paul instructed Timothy in this way in 1 Timothy 5, 1 and 3. "Do not rebuke an older man harshly, but exhort him as if he were your father. Treat younger men as brothers, older women as mothers, and younger women as sisters with absolute purity. Give proper recognition to those widows who are really in need." Jesus himself is concerned for all who are in need. Our world is hurting, and he is the healer. He wants to tell us to watch out for the world around us and to take care of them. Jesus himself wept over his city. When's the last time you drove through Newcastle weeping over your city? This is what it says in Luke chapter 19, 41. He wept as he approached Jerusalem and saw the city, he wept over it. We need to cry out to God. That's what we come and do on Wednesday nights, is we come to God, we cry out to him and ask him to break our hearts for our city. We ask him for his kingdom to come in Newcastle and Henry County. And listen, if you live in Muncie, we ask him for his kingdom to come in Muncie as well. Wherever you live, in your neighborhood, in your city. He wants us to not only care for our mothers and sisters and brothers and fathers, but he wants us to care for those who are our enemies as well. We look at the parable of the Good Samaritan in Luke chapter 10, verse 30 through 35. In reply, Jesus said, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho. When he was attacked by robbers, they stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side." Two men that you would assume would stop and help a fellow Jewish person saw him and went to the other side of the road. But then we see a Samaritan, the enemy of the Jews. It says, "But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came to where the man was. And when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, took care of him. The next day he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. 'Look after him,' he said. 'And when I return, I will embrace for you any extra expense you may have.'" We need to learn to care for our city, for our family, for our church family. We need to learn to care for each other. And I know we do such a good job, but we need to continue to do so. See, this Mother's Day, it isn't about Mary. It isn't about her love for her son, but the fact that Jesus loved his mother. But not only that, he's made a way for all of us to be his family. He sees your needs. He sees your hurts, and he has provided a way to help take care of those needs and hurts in the church as a body. We need to learn to be Christ to everyone who is hurting and in need. We need to learn where we fit in the body to help take care of the body. Jesus made his disciple John responsible for Mary. Today I want to ask you, who is he calling you to love, to take care of? But also we need to realize that we need to call on the name of the Lord Jesus to be saved. Ask him anything of the Father in his name, and it will be given to us. We are his family. We are his mother, his brother, his sisters. He will take care of us if we ask him today, just like he took care of Mary on the cross. And so today, this is what I want to do. As I was praying over this message, as I was praying over this service, I felt like God was wanting to heal people. I don't know if you noticed, that's been kind of the main theme throughout the worship, the prayer time, second half of my message. God wants to touch you today. And I'm not just talking about a physical healing. I'm not talking about some physical healing, which I am talking about that. But I'm also talking about a spiritual or an emotional heart issue healing. Some of you have been carrying around hurts and pains for maybe up to 40 years. As I was praying over this message, I saw in my spirit, in my heart, in my mind, that there are some people here that have scabs or scars or just sort of covering up a wound that never properly healed. And for some of you, you're going to need to come to the Father who is the master physician. You're going to need to let him cut it open so he can get out of that scar tissue so he can properly heal that wound. Because he wants you to be free from past hurts. He wants you to be free from things that have held you captive for so long. I don't know what they are. I'm not going to be Mr. Prophet Matt here and start calling out things in your life. But here's the deal. You know what you need to be healed from. You know. Recently, I've gone through an exercise where I've gone through my life, which was a scary ordeal because I don't know about you, but I don't like thinking back to hard times in my life. I'd rather just forget them and think about today. But see, God already started that process in me where I had to recognize certain things in my life that were painful, and I had to ask for forgiveness for holding on to that and let God heal them. God wants to do the same in you starting today. So, Kay, listen, I want you to stay back there today if you're okay, if that's okay with you. We didn't plan this yet. And I want you to find some quiet music on Spotify and just go ahead and sort of start playing it behind me. And I want everybody to go ahead, bow your heads and close your eyes just to get in a worship prayer posture. Before we ask God to heal us and before we start moving forward on this, I need to ask one question. Do you know Jesus today? Have you surrendered your life to him? You see, he didn't die on the cross just for his mother. He died on the cross for you so that you could be free from your sin, so you could have a new life. And today he wants you to confess your sins to him. He wants you to make him Lord of your life. What does that mean? It means you no longer are in control. You let him be in control. So what I want you to do is if you need Jesus today, I want you to, in your own words, I want you to say, Jesus, I need you. I'm a sinner. I know it. But Lord, please forgive me of all my sins. I need your forgiveness in my life. Whatever words you want to use. There's no wrong words.
You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are.
And now this is what I want to do. If you need healing today, which all of us do in some one extent of the or another, if you need healing today, I want you to make your way to the altar. Let go of your pride. Say, God, I need healing for this. Go ahead and stand up. I'll join you as well. I need healing in my life. And come on forward. And I'd love to pray with you this morning, but I also want you just to spend some time going after God, and then I'll come down and pray for you. Anybody else need healing this morning? Let God do what He needs to do, because He binds up the brokenhearted. He heals all of our wounds. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Come on up. You're staying at your seat. I want you to just worship God. Just worship Him this morning. Let's just honor Him this morning. I'm sure you know this song that's playing in the background. I don't want it any louder than it is. But just go ahead and start worshiping Him. Yes, Lord. He is a good Father. Yes, He cares for us today. Yes, yes, yes. Anybody else? No shame, only freedom. Only the beginning of freedom for you today. Or continuing of the freedom that you were already starting to experience at one time. He wants to pour out His... He just wants to pour out His Spirit on you this morning. Thank you, Lord, for caring for us.
But He brought me in, oh, His love for me, oh, His love for me. Who the sun sets free, who is free indeed. I'm a child of God, yes I am.
say this right now. I'm a child of God. Let's just sing this out. Okay, if you can turn it up just a little loud. I know we're halfway through the song. It's okay. Let's just make this our declaration this morning. Lord, thank you that we are your children, Father, that you see us, you care for us, you love us, Lord. I just rejoice in that. Whew. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we worship you this morning. Today, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bless you with the promises of God, which are yea and amen. I pray that the Holy Spirit will make you healthy and strong in your bodies, minds, and spirits to move in faith and expectancy. I pray that God's angels will be with you to protect you and to keep you. I pray that you will be I bless you with supernatural strength to turn your eyes from foolish, worthless, and evil things. That instead you'll behold the beauty of things that God has planned for you as you obey His word. I pray that God will give you success and prosperity in your businesses and places of labor as you acknowledge and obey the imperative of Scripture concerning the tithe. I pray that God will give you spiritual strength to overcome the evil one and to avoid temptation. That God's grace will be upon you to fulfill your dreams and visions. That goodness and mercy will follow you all the days of your long life. I pray that the Lord will bless you and keep you, that the Lord will make His face shine upon you and be gracious unto you, that the Lord will lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace. I bless you today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hey, I want to let you know that there is a photo booth opportunity once you leave the doors to the left. Ladies, do not forget your free gift. All ladies can receive this book. And so I want to make sure you guys get those on your way out. Other than that, I love you. And I encourage you and invite you to come join us on Wednesday night at 7 for prayer. It's only about 45 minutes long, so we don't keep you all night. Love you guys. Happy Mother's Day, ladies.